is negative of A cross B. Okay. B cross A is B A sine theta. B cross A and it goes anti-clockwise. If it goes anti-clockwise, its tendency, like this bottle going anti-clockwise, is to come out, right? So it comes out of the plane of the board, and hence is opposite in direction. And since their magnitudes are exactly equal and their directions are exactly opposite, so one is the negative of the other. So B cross A is minus of A cross B. Now based on whatever we have learnt about this, let us come to some conclusions. And the first conclusion is that our observations, okay, and our first observation is that A cross B is a vector. I'd like to add, it is a vector, fine, perpendicular to the plane containing A and B. Okay, that becomes very, very vital, that it is perpendicular to the plane containing A and B. Now, if A, B are non-zero vectors, if A and B are non-zero vectors, then A cross B is equal to zero if and only if, I double F, we write it as I double F, if and only if, what happens? Theta is equal to zero. Theta is equal to zero, why? Because this is sine theta. So this becomes zero when theta is equal to zero. That is, vectors are parallel. Or what is the other possibility? Theta is equal to pi. That is, vectors are anti-parallel. Vectors are anti-parallel. Okay? So either they are parallel or they are anti-parallel. Okay? Now what happens if theta is equal to pi by 2? So if theta is equal to pi by 2, at least mod of A cross B is what? What is the mod? Mod of A cross B is mod A mod B sine theta. Theta is 90, so it is mod A into mod B. That happens when theta is equal to pi by 2. Now, if I understand all this, then let us draw this Cartesian, right-handed Cartesian coordinate. This is X. This is Y. I'm drawing a small one. This is Z. This is origin. Now I have my unit vectors aligned along these directions, right? So this is my I cap. Fine. This is my I cap. This is my J cap. Length is? How much?
1.
Okay. And this is? K cap. Okay. Now if this is my I cap, I take I cap to J cap, then I go counterclockwise. Okay. I go counterclockwise and it comes out. So it is in the direction of, so my n cap is k cap, right? So if I do I cap cross j cap, this is equal to mod I cap into mod j cap into sine of the angle between the two is 90 degree into a normal vector perpendicular to both of them in the direction of, well, okay. So if I take it counterclockwise, it is k cap. So mod I cap is 1, mod j cap is 1, mod, so it is 1 into 1 into 1 into k cap. So that becomes equal to k cap. Okay. Now what is, so I'd like to write all the 9. I cross I will be what? I cross I cap will be what? I cross j cap will be what? And I cross k cap will be what? So I cross I caps in there, since they are parallel, it will be 0. I cross j we have just found out to be k cap. I cross k cap, okay? So this is my I, this is my I, this is my k. I cross k is downward, minus j cap. So minus j cap. Do you see why? Because it is a clockwise seeing from upwards and it goes in the direction of minus j. So minus j is the unit vector. And what happens here? J cross I cap is j cross I cap. J cross I cap becomes minus k cap. Actually, you could have come from here. I know that I cross j is k, so j cross I will be minus of that, because we have just seen that here. B cross A is minus of A cross B. So this is minus k cap. J cap cross j cap is 0. They are parallel vectors. In fact, 0 vector. Okay, O vector. J cap cross k cap. J cross k. See? J is upward. K is like this. Out of the board. J cross K. So looking from here, it is, looking from this side, it is counterclockwise. Counterclockwise, if I take this bottle counterclockwise, try to open it, it comes towards me. The cap linearly comes towards me. And that is the direction of I cap. Correct. So J cross K cap is I cap. So at times, you'll see, instead of going into all that, you can do something like this. This is I, this is J cap, this is K cap. So, and if you go like this. So, if you go in the same direction as the arrow, I cross J, you get K. We got K? I cross J cap, you will get K cap. See? J cross K cap, I got J cross K cap, I'll get I cap. The moment I change the direction, J cross I cap, I go to the third, J cross I cap will be minus. Why? I am going against the direction. That's a simple, easy way of keeping things in mind. That's all. Okay? So now we can use this if you want. K cross I cap, but not without ourselves verifying from here. So K cross I cap, K cross I. Looking from up, see? So K cross I, K cross I is minus j cap. Okay, I cross k cross I, sorry, k is out, k cross I cap, k cross I cap comes up, right, counterclockwise comes up. So it is j cap. It is like this bottle being opened. K cross I cap is counterclockwise, looking from up, it is coming towards me, it is opening, right? So it becomes J cap. K cross J, and let us verify it from here. K cross I cap becomes J cap. K cross J should now become minus I. Let us verify from here. K cross J. K is like that. K is like that. J is like that. K cross J is for me it is looking from here, it is clockwise. Okay, so if I go clockwise, the cap, the lid of this bottle goes in. Okay, so that is minus I cap. So minus I cap, K cross J is minus I cap. I have moved in the opposite direction. K cross K cap, K cap cross K cap is 0. Okay, but we'll be eventually using this. Fine, we'll be eventually using that. Now this formula also can be used to find out the angle. So I have A cross B, rather mod of A cross B is mod A mod B into sine theta. So sine theta is equal to mod of A cross B upon mod A into mod B. Okay, so is that sine theta is that. Okay, then vector product is not commutative. Let us include it as a vector product is not commutative. In fact, it becomes negative. So A cross B becomes minus of B cross A, right? Now there's an interesting thing about the vectors. It is this. If say this vector A forms this side of a parallelogram, this is your A, and this is B. Okay? Now just see, if I tend to form a parallelogram with these two as the sides, and what is the area of the parallelogram? Area of the parallelogram. What is the area of the parallelogram with A and B as its sides? What is the area? If this is theta, then this is what? This is B sine theta. And you know that it is any of the sides multiplied by the altitude, right? So area of the parallelogram becomes A into B sine theta. Now it's very interesting. Actually, this is what? Mod of A cross B. Do we get that? This is mod of A cross B. So, do I erase this? The definition I won't, this explanation I will. Okay? So let me clear some space. Fine. Now if it were a triangle which was composed of A and B as sides, so you see, do I make it 8? Yes. So if it were a triangle with A and B as sides, then we immediately realize that its area will be its area will be half of the area of this parallelogram, and we have just now found out the area of this parallelogram. So area of the triangle is, area of this triangle is half of it. So is not, is it not? OAB. So area of triangle OAB is equal to half of mod A cross B. No, the relationship seems to be strange, but it's really such a coincidence, and it's so easily found out. Okay. Okay.